Welcome to the third day of Lean for the Curious Mathematician. In this session, we will talk about structures and classes. So before we start, let me tell you how to get access to this file, which I'm working on and which also contains the exercises for this session. So to do this, you need to update the repository you cloned yesterday. So you have to open a terminal and go to lftcm2020, the directory you cloned before. And then you have to run git pull. Now it is important, git pull will only work if you have no local changes to any of the existing files in your repository. So if you made the exercises yesterday directly in the files, and you edited some of those files, make sure to first copy those files to a backup version as a local copy, and then run git checkout dash dash dot. Do be warned though when running this command. This command will restore all files in your repository to their version known to git. So this might undo changes you made locally to the file. So that's why I recommend backing up the files first by copying them. Then run git pull, and then run lean project getmathlib cache to get the latest version of mathlib for the repository. And after that, you can open this file in VS Code, and this file is located in the exercises sources folder from Wednesday morning. Okay, so now that's out of the way, and we can start about structures in Lean. So structures are a way of bundling information together. So for example, if we want to talk, if we want to define the type of even natural numbers, then in Lean, that makes sense as a pair consisting first of a natural number and then secondly a proof that it is a natural number. And something like that can be done with structures. So how to do that is we write structure, then the name of the structure. So in this case, I'm going to call it even natural number. And then we write the type. The type can often be omitted, but in this case, I just say it has type type. So that is the universe of types. And then I say, well, an even natural number has two fields. First, it has a natural number n. And secondly, it has a proof, which I call even n, that n is even. So these two things in parentheses, these are called the fields of the structure. Those are the components of an object of this structure. So if I have an even natural number, it has two components. It has a component n and a component even n. And here are some other examples of structures. So for example, here we have a structure is even cube above 100. This is a structure that takes n as an argument and returns a proposition. So it's really a predicate on the natural numbers. And this is a predicate that states three things. It states that n is even, it states that n is a cube of another natural number, and it states that n is greater than 100. So this structure should really be thought of as the conjunction of these three things, but to every property individually, we give like a name. So even is cube and GT 100. And here's another example. Structure, so the bounds of a function. So if I have a function from nat to nat, I can look at all the upper bounds of this function. And so here I declare that bounds consist of a natural number n, a natural number which I call bound, and then a proof that the bound is all greater than all values of f. And I've omitted here the type of the structure, and you can do that, and Lean will figure out what the type is itself. So in this case, it will just put it in type. So to view the fields of a structure, you can use the print command that shows, let me move this out of the way, that shows in the info view here, the structure itself and the type of all the fields. So for example, for the even natural number, if I have an even natural number, then I have this field even natural number dot n, which corresponds to this n I have had here, and it returns a natural number. And so these are also, these fields also give the projections of a structure, and that is the way you use a structure. So for example, let's work a little bit with the projections of this predicate that n is an even cube above 100. So to get then the information that n is greater than 100, that was this third field gt100. So one thing I can do is just apply the function is even cube above 100. The tab completion is already saying that. And then I can use the projection gt100 and apply it to hn. Hn in this case is the proof that n is an even cube above 100. And this is a projection saying that n is greater than 100. So as you can imagine, writing this full name out every time gets cumbersome. So there are a couple of ways we can do, a couple of things we can do to shorten this name. So the first thing we can do is we can open this namespace. So every structure creates a namespace which is given by its name, and all the fields are declarations in that namespace. So if we open this namespace, we shorten all the names. And now, instead of writing this whole prefix, we can just write gt100, the name of the field applied to hn. This is already better. Because I only have to open namespace once, and then I can apply this projection like multiple times. But it's still cumbersome to open all these namespaces. So instead, what we do is, one thing we can do is use projection notation. So that is a way to write this projection without opening any namespaces. So If I have hn, which is of type is even cube above 100 applied to n, I can do the projection hn dot, and then the projection I want, gt100. And this is interpreted in exactly the same way as the previous two examples. So it's still the field gt100 applied to the variable hn. And so it will use the type of hn, which is even cube above 100, that n is an even cube above 100, and then it uses the type to figure out what this projection is. Its projection in the this namespace is even cube above 100. And so here's another example where we get multiple projections. And a third example, a third way to do the projections is to just write dot one. So if I want to extract the free fields from the projection, I can use these curly brackets to get a conjunction. And then in the first case, I have to show that n is even, which you see here on the right. And that is the first projection of hn, so I can just write hn.1. And for the second projection, I can use write hn.2, and for the third projection, hn.3. So this is also a convenient way to get the projections of a structure. So this predicate is even cube above 100, and this conjunction of free properties, these are really, can be thought of as the same predicate. So instead of defining a structure with free fields, I could just write this conjunction. But if you write this conjunction, you don't get the named fields. You always have to say, oh, well, the left conjunct, and that can get bothersome, especially if you have a lot of conjuncts. So for this even natural number, so we had this other example, even natural number. The other structure, which was a natural number n, together with a proof that n is even. And another way to write that down is using subtypes. So an even natural number is really a subtype of the natural numbers. And in Lean, we can write that by writing the n colon nat, and then we do a double slash, and then we write even n. And this notation, so within curly braces and the double slash, this is the notation for a subtype. And this is a different way of writing down a structure. So this is the same as a structure with a field that n is a natural number and n is even. And with a subtype, this always has to be a proposition. And this notation looks very similar to the set comprehension notation, which we saw yesterday. So here's an example where I declare sets of natural numbers. And with the set comprehension notation, we have to use this pipe. And so the difference between these notations is that double slash is for subtypes and the pipe is for set comprehension. Now the next question is, how do we construct objects of a structure? Like, how do we construct an even natural number if we have like a subtype, either have formulated this as a subtype or formulated it as a structure? So as an example here, I have these two different notation of even natural number, the one with a structure, and the primed one, which is defined as a subtype over here. And so we can, as a toy example, just give a function from one type to the other. And we can do that by introducing n, which is an even natural number. And now I have to give an even natural number prime. And I can do this with these pointy braces you've already seen for conjunctions. So these pointy brackets, they actually work for all structures and also for subtypes and even existential statements. And and Lean will figure out what structure you are trying to make an object of from the context. And so in this case, I have to, from an even natural number, get a natural number, which is the first projection of n. So I can write n.1 or n.n, because I called the name of the projection also n, which was maybe not the nicest name. And then for the second projection, I can write n.2 or n.underscore n. So this is a way to construct objects of a particular structure. And here's another example with to get a function from is even cube above 100 to is even cube above 100 prime. Another way to do this is to use the structure notation. So what we can do is here's an example. I'm defining the function the other way around. Now I have to provide an even natural number. And so this even natural number is a structure, with two fields, n and even n. And so this structure notation allows you in curly braces to write just the value of the individual fields individually, and you name the fields, and you can specify them in any order. So I say that, well, the n field of the even natural number is n.1, the first projection of this even natural number prime, and the field for even n is n.2, the second projection. And if Lean can figure it out from the context, this name I provide here for the structure notation is optional, so I can remove it, and Lean will know that I'm constructing an even natural number, because in the type I told that was what I was doing. And here's another example where I do the same, but for the even cubes above 100. And so in this example, actually, there's one interesting thing to note. So when you do write a lambda abstraction, you can also destruct a structure immediately using these curly braces. This is basically the same as the R intro, which we saw yesterday, except that the lambda cannot do disjunctive pattern matching, only conjunctive ones, so only with the curly braces. So, and here's the second exercise. And this is the first video lecture for this session. You can now try exercise 1 and 2, and after you're done with that, please come back for the second video.